amina.
Today we are so privileged.
Olwaleero tuweereddwa nnyo omukisa.
We have a man of God in the house.
Tulina omusajja wa Katonda mu nyumba leero.
He has actually traveled with some people. He will introduce them.
Ayina abantu batamuddeko n'abeera gya banjula.
He has preached here several times before.
Abadde abuuliraana emirundi egiwerako.
His wife recently preached and ministered to the ladies not long ago.
Era mukyala we banga tono emabega ono yogerako eri abakyala.
And I was told she was a blessing. I missed the meeting because I realized I'm not a woman, so I missed.
Nasubwa okubeera mu lukungaana kuba natizula sali mukyala naye nti yali mukisa eri abakyala abakanisa eno.
Praise be to God. So next time, ladies, invite us.
Abakyala oluddako mutwitte.
Twenyigiremu. We invite you next time.
Omulundi oguddako abaami
mujja ne musolosa ne muyingira. So the preacher today,
omubuulizi olwaleero,
is Pastor James Kato.
Ye musumba James Kato.
He's an apostle by calling.
Era mutume mukuyitibwa.
He's the senior pastor of Jesus Worship Center.
Ye musumba omukulu oba Jesus Worship Center.
A very powerful, dynamic preacher.
Era mubuulizi w'amaanyi.
I remember last time he dissected the book of Joel and I said, where did this man get all these wonderful
ideas?
Praise the Lord. So can you please welcome with me Pastor Kato as he comes to give us the word. A big shout from Gaba. Glory be to Jesus Christ. Man of God, here it is. Glory to God.
Hallelujah. Mukama ebazibe nyo.
Praise the Lord.
Nsanyuse nyo okubeera nakawungeezi ka leero.
I'm so glad to be here tonight.
Nebaza Mukama atuleese wano naku lwaleero.
I thank God so much who has brought us tonight.
Nebaza Mukama akuyisiza mu byonna byakuyisizaamu.
Thank God who has seen you through whatever he has seen you through.
Njagala okwanjula abantu be nazze nabo.
I would like to introduce the people I came with.
Musumba Peter si mugenyi wano.
Pastor Peter is not new here.
Ye Peter Kato.
Peter Kato.
Wasumba Matuga.
He's a pastor of Matuga. Wherever you forget his name, you remember mine, you have remembered his. If you miss my Chiganda name, then you remember your pastor's name. Your first pastor's first name, you would have remembered. Those of you who know the journey to Matuga, the distance,
Bombo Road.
The Bombo Road.
Mo COVID,
during COVID, he used to move by foot.
Okuva Echebando Paka e Matuga.
From Echebando on Gayaza Road to Matuga.
Kubanga motoka za febaite banazita.
Because they had not allowed public transport or private transport to move.
Ngatambula na agenda na tambula na komao.
So he would walk to and from Matuga.
Okulambula endiga zeyo.
To go and see the sheep, how they are doing.
Buyampo bujuli zinenga mukama zebuja.
When he gave me that testimony, I said, Lord, revive me.
Kubanga nalisima njubaze nsobolo bikole na kuzina.
Because I don't know if I can do such things these days.
Tumukubile kumungalo olwenjala no mulilo byali.
So let us clap our hands to him for the hunger and for such a grace.
Mukama yebazibe.
Praise the Lord.
Nazene musumba Chiwalabye.
I came from Pastor Chiwalabye. With Pastor Chiwalabye.
Ngenda kumusaba abawubireko.
Well, I will ask him to wave to you.
Amina.
Amen.
Gaba Community Church wafe.
Gaba Community Church is our home. So whenever we come here, we feel at home. Whenever we are at our place, we miss you. When I drove to this place, I began to ask for fish. Because here, if you put your hook down there, by the end of the service, you have a narrow patch. So we are going to leave where we stay and come and live in this church. Near the lake and catch fish for free. We love this house. We love Pastor Peter.
Mama Irene,
and Mama Irene, we love you so much. I've been following you. The kind of meetings you've been doing in the pastors. God will give us the grace to host you in our pastors there. We have a very big family of pastors. And we trust that such a great work you've done in others will come and do it in our pastors.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to talk about a few books I came with. About 4 years ago, I released this book from the U.S. You can find it on Amazon. It's called The Weight of His Name. In the year 2000, I went all around East Africa doing gospel crusades. And I became so amazed about the miracles that can happen spontaneously just by calling on His name. Actually, that's why our church is called Jesus Worship Center. Because the Lord in those days visited me and revealed to me the greatness of His name. But I discovered that many people don't know how to use it. They don't know that the name is the person. And so this is such a blessing. It's available at 20,000. Now, is there any lady here? And you are sure you have the biggest number of children that you produce biologically? I want to give you this book. How many? Five. Should she speak? How many, ma'am? Six. Okay, you five sit down, six stand up. Any other one here? How many?
Six.
Now how are we going to?
Yeah?
Do we tear this one apart into two? Okay, let have this book. Bless it too. In the COVID year, I wrote another book called The Five Laws of Life. I realized that there are things we can, principles we can inculcate in our life and automatically advance in life. So I talk about the law of commitment, the law of generosity, the law of kindness, the law of loyalty, and the law of honor. I've only taken this book to South Africa, but it's available tonight. I think I have about 13 copies at 20,000. Now, if you are here and you are sure that your dad has the largest number of children, I'm going to give you this book. Mami Muloza, you will be surprised.
You think she's going to be the one?
Charles, how many?
Charles, Mameka.
13.
30.
How many? Yours has 22.
22.
Mama, I read. 30. Where? This is 30 stand up.
30.
If somebody beats you, then you sit down. My beautiful sister. 37. Sit down.
Chitufu. Asatu musambu.
Anybody that wants to beat my sister here? My sister, come and have this book. The Lord richly bless you.
Now, also in the COVID year, I released another book.
Era mwaka ogw'omuggalo nawandiika ekitabo ekirala.
This one is called Divine Dreams for Personal Direction.
Kino kiyitibwa ebirooto ebiva eri Katonda okulungamya omuntu.
How many of you are dreamers? When you sleep, you dream.
Bameka kumenga bweba korote ebirooto.
You need this book.
Weetaagayo ku kitabo kino.
There are 8 categories of the dreams you receive.
Waliwo ebikamu naana ebyebirooto byofuna.
The most frequent dream you will receive is what they call the identity dream.
Ekirooto ekisinga byosinga okufuna byebirooto ebyo ebiraga kikyoli ebikwanjulira kikyoli.
Where the Lord is emphasizing how heaven perceives you.
Nga Mukama ayongera okunnyonnyola kiki eggulu kye likulabamu.
Until you agree with that,
okutuusa ng'okkiriziganyiza nakyo,
your anointing will never befriend you.
Amafuta go tegali kufuukira ga mukwano gy'oli.
And then you get predictive dreams.
N'ofuna ebirooto ebikubuulira gy'olaga.
Where you foresee things that are going to happen.
Ng'olaba ebintu ebigenda okubaawo.
Then you get directional dreams.
N'ofuna ebirooto ebikuwa endagiriro oba ebikulagirira ekyokkola.
Now those ones are very important.
Ate n'ebyo ebirooto bikulu nnyo.
Because they dictate that you have got to be in particular places at particular time.
Kubanga bikutegeeza nti olina okubeera mu kifo gundi mu ssaawa bweziti mu nnaku bweziti mu biro bwebi.
Specific places you've been called to.
Ebifo ebyenjawulo oba ebyenkizo by'olina okubeeramu.
Then you get discernment dreams.
N'ofuna ebirooto ebyokwawula.
Where you discern what is behind a situation.
Woyawulira n'otegeera n'okebera embeera n'olaba kiki ekiri emabega waayo.
Then you get espionage dreams.
N'ofuna ebirooto eby'obukessi.
Where you go into meetings unawares.
N'ogenda mu nkuŋŋaana mu birooto byo nga tebategedde nti wazze.
And you eavesdrips on them whatever they're talking about.
N'olyoka nno owulira byonna bye bakwogerako.
Then you get dreams of divine operation.
N'ofuna ebirooto eby'okukola kw'obwakatonda.
Those are not promises.
Ng'ebyo ebirooto si bisuubizo.
In those dreams God visits you.
Mu birooto mu kirooto kyennyini Katonda akukyalira.
And he works on you.
N'akukolamu omulimu.
And you wake up a finished day.
Ozuukuka ebintu yabimaliriza dda.
So if you're a dreamer,
bw'obanga oli mulosi,
steward your dreams.
Ebirooto byo biterekenga.
Don't play games with them.
Ebirooto tomala gasuulawo ng'obigalabanja.
As I want you to learn,
njagala oyige,
how to interpret your own dreams.
Engeri gy'ovunulamu ebirooto byo.
So this book is available.
Kati ekitabo kino nakyo weekiri.
I think I have about 23 copies.
Ndowooza ninayo kopi nga 23.
Now this one is at 30,000.
Kino kyo kya mitwalo 3.
I want to give it to the longest member of this church.
Njagala kuwa member akyasinze okulwa mu kanisa eno.
Other than Pastor Peter, Pastor Peter, that would not be fair. Pastor
Irene,
no. Who is it?
Ani ayasinze okulwa wano ennyo?
Is it Jemima?
Jemima kuwa akyasinze.
I don't know whether she knows whether she's my OG.
Simanyi oba akimanyi nga twasomako naye.
We are at university together.
Ku university twaliyo fenna.
Can we celebrate her?
Tumusanyukireko.
The Lord richly bless you,
Mukama akuwere nnyo ddala omukisa.
I really want you to steward your dreams, each one of you.
Njagala buli omu nandyagadde buli omu atereke bulungi ebirooto bye.
And of course our dreams talk to each other.
Ate ebirooto byaffe tusobola okubikozesa okwogeraganya.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't know how long am I speaking for. I can do 7 hours, whichever.
Nkozese esaawa nga musanvu.
Good. Good. That's good. Amen.
Amen.
Raise your hands above your head. Father, we come to you. We ask that your word will come to us. We ask that you open us up body, spirit, and soul. Let your word enter. We ask that you unfold the power of your word to affect every facet of existence. We will not be the same again. Open our eyes to see Jesus. Cause us to fall in love with him again, that we may serve him the rest of our days. And everybody said amen. Now I'm aware that this year in this house is a year of restoration, and I'm confident that the Lord is going to restore us in many ways. But praying over these days that I'm with you, I felt the Lord lead me to teach in two
personal prayer lives.
Nawulidenga mukama anungamya okusomesa kukufula obulamu obu okusaba okwo buli muntu sekinomo.
Your personal prayer when all of us are not here.
Okuzimba obulamu bwo okusaba abalala bonanga tebali wo era nga tebali akulira.
And so today I'm going to share with you.
Kati olwangenda gabana namwe.
The 6 to 7 legs of prayer that you need.
Amaguru mukago bamusanvu ago okusaba ko wetaga.
For you to sustain your personal prayer life. Now, as a traveling minister, I change environments. And at times it's hard to pray from different places. When I travel away from home, I'm left all to myself. It's only my personal prayer life and the strength thereof that can sustain me in unique territories. Years ago, when Ugandans began to go into the diaspora, many of them fell away from the Lord because all they had in their lives was corporate prayer. There are places where corporate prayer cannot sustain you.
You
need to have a strong personal prayer life. Why? Because it's only your personal prayer life that can anchor the truths of God in your life. It's not all about assenting to correct theology. What you know, you must truly believe. And what you believe must become experiential. Christianity was intended to be experiential. That's why it was born on the day of Pentecost. When it was born, people heard things. People saw flames. People were touched by the wind. People behaved as if they were drunk. Christianity is experiential. Whatever correct theology you have, it has got to be anchored in personal experience. And that which anchors it in your life is a personal prayer life. When you have a personal prayer life, you can fully enjoy God in a personal way. The God of your pastor is not enough for you. The God of your father is not enough for you. You need your own God to know him in a personal way, to know him in a real way. What makes that happen is a personal prayer life. In a few minutes I'm going to begin to preach, but just before I do, I want to let you know, until you pray, you will never pray. And you will never grow in your prayer life. No matter how many books you read, no matter how much inspiration you take in, you begin to pray when you begin to pray. Even if you have only 2 words, if you can say them to God, your prayer journey has
started.
Olugendo olw'okusaba luba lutandise.
Matthew chapter 6 and verse 6.
Mattayo sura mukaga olunyuma mukaga.
But when you pray,
naye bwe musabanga,
go into your room and shut the door.
Yingiranga mu kisenge kyo galewo oluggi.
And pray to your father who is in secret.
Osabe kitaawo ali mu kyama.
Jesus never says if you pray.
Yesu teyagamba nti singa mukali batanda ne musaba.
He said when you pray.
Yagamba bwe munatuuka ngekiseera nga muteekwa okusaba ne musaba.
Because as a disciple of Christ,
kubanga ng'omuyigirizwa wa Kristo,
you must have a personal prayer life.
Oteekeddwa okuba n'obulamu obw'okusaba obwa ssekinnoomu.
Luke 18 and verses 1.
Luka 18 olunyo olusooka.
And he told them a parable.
Awono n'abagerera olugero.
To the effect that they ought always to pray.
Bwe kibagwaniranga okusaba bulijjo.
And not lose heart.
Era obutakoowanga.
They ought to pray always.
Nga balina okusabanga bulijjo.
They ought to pray daily.
Balina okusaba buli lukya.
They ought to pray personally.
Balina okusabanga ssekinnoomu.
If they don't lose heart.
Bwe babanga tebasirike tebagwemu maanyi.
If they overcome discouragement.
Bwe babanga banaawangula okumalibwamu amaanyi.
They will never stop praying.
Tebateekwa kulekerawo okusaba.
They ought to pray always.
Bateekeddwa okusaba bulijjo.
Personal prayer life.
Obulamu obw'okusaba ssekinnoomu.
Makes you a possessor of the promises of God.
Bukuleetera okubanga gw'oli musika ow'ebisuubizo bya Katonda.
Prophecies have come true.
Obunabbi bungi obutuukiridde.
Dreams have come true.
Ebirooto bituukiridde.
Because I pray personally.
Kubanga nze eby'okusaba mbyekwatiramu ssekinnoomu.
I pray on a daily basis.
Nsaba buli lunaku olukya.
And by the grace of God.
Era olw'ekisa kya Katonda.
Many of the things that he has revealed to me.
Ebingi ku bintu Katonda byambikulidde.
I've seen them come to pass.
Mbirabye nga bituukirira.
1992 I had a dream.
Kumulwenda kyenda mu ebiri nalota ekirooto.
I was at the university.
Nali nga nsoma ku university.
And in my dream.
Mu kirooto kyange.
A nation in South Africa.
Eggwanga mu South Africa.
Had declared a national day of prayer and fasting.
Baali balangiridde olunaku olw'okusaba n'okusiiba olw'eggwanga eddamba.
And so I went to the university fellowship.
Nengenda mu fellowship ya university.
And I prophesied.
Nendagula.
And I said there is a nation in the southern part of
Bagamba maserengeta Africa wali egwanga.
He's going to announce a day of prayer.
Bagenda kulangiria yo lunaku olw'okusaba.
But it's also going to be a day of fasting.
Era lugenda kuba lunaku olw'okusiiba.
Finish university in 1994.
Namala university mu 94.
And nothing like that had happened.
Ngekintu w'ekitoto kibangayo.
And I said maybe I missed it.
Nengamba oba oliawo saalaba bulungi.
In 2016, on the 18th of October, the nation of
Zambia
declared a national day of prayer and fasting. And since 2016, it's an annual practice for the entire nation. That is one of the many dreams, one of the many promises that I've encountered in my life. There are things that God has done. There are things God has not yet done. When I look at the things that he has done, I am sure that those that have not yet happened, they are going to happen. In my dreams, I have seen money. So I know I'm a millionaire. Because my dreams say so. The one who has made the others happen is also going to make this one happen. Now some of you are saying this is a crazy man. I wonder how Julie puts up with him. But I live in the crazy world. Because God himself is a mystery. Until you have a strong personal prayer life, there are promises that will elude you. It is only personal prayer lives that enables you to do business with God. I was teaching the pastors in Worship Harvest recently, and I was telling them it's not enough to teach, it's not enough to preach. After you have told the word, you bring the congregation before the Lord on your knees and you travail, and no, you as the pastor,
osindire maso ga mukama,
and you travel before the Lord
osinde maso ga katonda
until they crack a revelation
okutusanga okubikulirwa bakuwambye bakutute
of everything you are teaching about
okwecho chobado basomesa chona.
You have to pray them into the formation of Christ
olino kusaba no bayingisa muchikura chobuna muchoyagala baberemo.
So prayer is doing business with God.
Katyo kusaba kwe kusubulaganya ne katonda.
If I continue, I want to declare.
Ngasina genda maso kanangirire.
In your family.
Mu famile yo.
Nothing is impossible
to God. Tewali wochire makatonda.
In your marriage.
Mu bufumba bwo.
Nothing is impossible to God.
Tewali chire makatonda.
In your body.
Mu mubiri gwo.
Nothing is impossible to God.
Tewali chire makatonda.
In your economics.
Mu byenfuna byo.
Situations of your business. Nothing is impossible to God. If you can pray about it, He will do something about it. If you can pray about it, He will do something about it. When you have a personal prayer life, thank you, Lord, you do business with God. So let's go with the seven legs. Number one. Personal prayer life begins with signing up. And you say, I'm signing up, I'm going to be prayerful. In my family, I'll be the prayerful one. In my department, I'm going to be the prayerful one. 1988. I signed up. I visited a family. And there was a 16-year-old girl. She said she was in full-time ministry. I said, what does that mean? And she said, I serve the Lord full-time. I asked her, what do you do when the service is over? She said, I pray. I asked her, how long do you pray? She said, 6 hours or 7 hours. I said, what? 6 hours. He said, you can do it. So I went into the Anglican church. Kakajo Church of Uganda.
This Kakajo Church of Uganda.
And I locked myself in the church. And I said, I'm going to pray for 6 hours. And I prayed. And I dozed. And I prayed. And I thought it was a long time. And it was only 20 minutes. And I hadn't prayed before. And so I had to repeat the Lord's Prayer maybe 100 times. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Weak as I was, I had signed up. I had started on the journey. Today the victory I've seen in prayer is because I signed up. Nobody signs up for you concerning prayer. You say you determine by yourself and say, I'm going to pray. Hear the words of Job. In Job 5 and verses number 8 to 12. He says, as for me, I would seek God, and to God will I commit my cause. Who does great things and unsearchable, marvelous things without number.
He gives rain on the earth and sends waters on the fields. He sets on high those who are lowless, and those who mourn are lifted to safety. He frustrates the devices of the crafty so that their hands achieve no success. Job says, I'm going to seek God. I am signing up. I'm starting on this journey. Personal prayer life begins by signing up. Bible talks about Uzziah in 2 Chronicles 26 and verses number 5. He says he set himself to seek God in the days of Zechariah, who instructed him in the fear of God. And as long as he sought the Lord, God made him to prosper. Bible declares they were priests. They were men of God around him. But he made the decision himself. He set himself to seek the Lord. Will you sign up to become prayerful in your life? Will you sign up to find time daily? Will you sign up to be regular on your prayer altar? Number one, it begins by signing up. Number two, you need to set a time and you need to find a place. You ask people, when do you pray? They say, when I wake up. When the sleep is over, that's when I pray. The most popular answer is, when I find time. You can never develop a strong personal prayer life until you have designated a time. Until you have gazetted a time period. And you say, this is going to be my time of prayer. My time of prayer is 2 a.m. to 6 a.m. I do that daily. When it was the COVID time, it was 8 p.m. to 7 a.m. I choose the night time because everybody in my house is sleeping. Nobody disturbs me. The neighborhood where we stay is very noisy. But at 2 a.m. everybody is sleeping. Heaven knows when it's 2 a.m. It has to receive the calls of James Kato. That is my time I've chosen. You have to choose a time. And you have to choose a place. Personally, I pray for my living room. I'm religiously seated on a particular chair. That's where I kneel down before. I love to pray on my knees. When I get to that chair, in our living room, my psychology is rearranged to realize that I'm entering the Holy of Holies.
utukuvu wa watukuvu.
You are psychological information.
Omanyi Katonda yakukola ngoine enchukachuka zebirowozo zinawe zitebenkera newe zichukira.
So if you keep on mixing up places,
kati bwobanga gwe wakasabirako mufumbira ate ogendako mudiro ngabuli kasero chuse ebifo,
you are going to confuse your psychology.
Ogenda kutabula tabula endowoza zo.
You have to set a time. You have to set a place.
No funa nechifo.
This is how Daniel does it.
Daniel
chapter 6
Daniel
and verses number 10. And when Daniel knew that the document had been signed, he went into his house where he had windows in his upper chamber. He opened them towards Jerusalem. He got down on his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before God, as he had done previously. He chose a room in his house. It was the upper chamber. He always prayed with open windows. Because Solomon besought the Lord in 2 Chronicles 7 that whenever we are taken into captivity, when we pray towards this place, answer our prayers. So he opens the windows towards Jerusalem. Although he's in Babylon and he prays, he's praying 3 times a day, because that's how the Hebrew do it. Psalm 55 and verse 17, evening and morning and noontime will I pray. I'll cry aloud because you will hear me. But notice that he prays at a particular time, and Daniel prays in a particular place. Can you determine a time tonight? I don't hear you. Can you determine a time tonight? And you say, in my times, this is my time of prayer. Can you determine a place? Most of the people I pastor, they have one room, the houses, but I teach them, even in that one room, gazette a spot where you come before the Lord and call upon his name. Leg number 3. You can never have a strong personal prayer life until you are consistent. Look 18 and verses 1 to 5. And he told them a parable to the effect that they all ought always to pray and not to lose heart. And he said, in a certain city there was a judge who neither feared God nor respected man. And there was a widow in the city who kept coming to him and said, give me justice against my adversary. For a while he refused, but afterward he said unto himself, though I neither fear God nor respect man, yet because this widow keeps bothering me, I will give her justice, so that she may not beat me up down because of her continual coming. She came to the judge daily. She came to the judge daily. That's how you build a personal prayer life. You keep your prayer appointments. Even when I am tired, even when I am sleepy, I have to keep my prayer appointment. And that's
that's what strengthens me. Luke 11 and verses 9 to 10. And I tell you, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door shall be opened unto you. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. To the one who knocks, it will be opened. In the tense in which this scripture is written, it literally means ask and keep on asking. Seek and keep on seeking. Knock and keep on knocking. Last Saturday night I prayed. This morning I prayed. Tomorrow morning I'm going to pray. Next month I'm going to pray. You have to be consistent. Now listen to me, write this down. When you are consistent in your prayer time, you become used to your voice. In your prayers, you must be used to your voice. Your voice is an ambient environment. Your voice is a good environment. It's a good atmosphere. I love how other people pray. But I enjoy my voice best. Are you still following me? Because over the last 30 years, I have established my voice in the heavenlies. And by the way, people pray on music. I've not yet found good music other than my music. So when I play the keyboard in my prayer time, and I sing my songs, the songs I've written, they're over 200, I record them. So I play them to myself. It takes me only 2 minutes to break through. I love my voice. When you pray consistently, you get used to your voice. Number two, your prayer style becomes established. Your prayer style. It is unique and original. I pray like James Kato. One of the ways I pray through is through the book of Psalms. I've been doing this for the last 30 years. I can know the next word. If people pray with me, they find it hard. At times I pray with gymnastics. I pray like Dingo Man. Are you hearing what I'm talking about? When you pray consistently, your prayer style is established. You consolidate the most recent prayer grace and you stretch to the next level. Whenever you pray, you break through. When you break through, you acquire a new grace. But if you don't pray consistently,
The grace of yesterday fizzles away. You only consolidate what you acquire by praying consistently. When you pray consistently, it moves your body and your psyche into a new normal. When you pray again and again for 1 hour, 1 hour becomes your new normal. When you pray for 2 hours and you pray 2 hours again, 2 hours becomes your new normal. So consistency makes you consolidate that grace and moves your body into that new normal. Number 4 is persistence. Persisting in prayer like the widow. We have read about the widow in Luke chapter 18. But persistence in prayer, it means being stubborn and refusing to quit. Whoever embarks on the journey of prayer has many opportunities to quit. Those who keep on praying are simply because they are stubborn. When I am tired, I stubbornly refuse to quit. When I am sleepy, I stubbornly refuse to quit. When I'm distracted, I stubbornly refuse to quit. When I stubbornly refuse to quit, I break into the second hour. And I break into the third hour. And I break into the fourth hour. And I break into the ninth hour. I refuse to quit. I persist it. Persistence means you continue to do it even when you don't feel it. There are times when you pray and you don't feel it, because prayer is not feeling. Prayer is believing. Those who come to God must believe that He is, and that is a reward of them that seek Him diligently. Number 5. If you're going to build a strong personal prayer life, you are going to build it on pursuit. What do you pursue in prayer? I want to advise you not to have becoming a prayer warrior as your goal. I want to become a prayer warrior. That's why I'm praying. What does that mean? Other people say, I want my needs met. So what if he meets all of them? Will you have zero prayer in your life? Some people pray because of the fire. because of the storm. What if it all comes down? The greatest pursuit is pursuing God, seeking to see Him, seeking to know Him. You are praying because you want Him to become real. I have heard John say that the one we touched, the one we heard, the one we walked with is the one we are bringing to you. I want to touch Him like John. I want to see Him like John. I want to feel Him like John. I pray because I want Him. I pray because I want to see Him. What started us on praying? What started us on praying is T.L. Osborne's words.
T.L.
Osborne said,
T.L. Osborne yagamba,
the day you see Jesus,
Yesu,
you will never be the same again. That's what started me off. So I went into the forest for months,
kumaremiezi,
spending the nights there,
gansurayo,
because I know the day I see Him, I will never be the same again. And so I found myself praying for 14 hours because I was pursuing Him. Many of the things that I thought were impossible, today I have seen them in my life. I challenge you to seek Him. I challenge you to desire to touch Him. Psalm 104 and verses number 4. Seek the Lord and His strength. Seek His presence continually. Isaiah 64 and verses number 7. He says, there is no one who calls upon your name who rouses himself to take a hold of you. The King James says, there is nobody who stirs up himself to grow a hold of you. If you are listening to me, wave to me. Because I want you to hear this. God is grabbable. God is grabbable. God is grabbable. Even when your homestead is infested with witchcraft, you can grab God and take Him back home with you. You can tell your husband, I've found Him. T.L. Osborne went into a meeting. William Branham was preaching. And he saw the miracles. And God told him, you can do it. He went back home. He locked himself into the garage. And he told Daisy, I'm not coming back to you until I've seen Jesus. After 3 days, Jesus appeared to him. And he said, I am Jesus. Go back and preach. Wherever you go, I'm going to be with you, and I will perform miracles, signs and wonders. He came out of the garage and said, Daisy, I've seen Him. So Daisy said, grab a hold of the babies. I'm also going into the garage. I'll not come back until I've seen Him. Thanks be to God that Daisy found Him too. I'm here to declare, God is grabbable. God is findable. Are you able to stir up yourself? Are you able to say enough is enough? Are you able to say, I've dwelt on this mountain for a long time? Are you able to discern these days that in this season of fasting in Gaba Community Church, they declared it for me. They They declared it for my house. They declared it for my marriage. I'm going to find him. I'm anointed to declare. The Lord is going to appear to you. The Lord is going to visit you. The Lord is going to reach out to you. I declare. One no eye has seen. One no ear has heard. What has not yet entered the heart of any man. That's what God has prepared for you. From the foundations of the world. He's findable. Listen to me, everybody. There is a realm in God that you haven't found yet. You don't have to have what everybody has. I declare you are going to be the pioneer. You are going to touch it first. You are going to experience it first. Heaven is waiting for you. The Bible declares deep calls unto deep. In Psalm 42, there are depths in God that Kampala has never seen. There are depths in God Kampala has never seen. 2021, I want you to find him and put on a conference for us. I'm going to sign up as number one that you may teach us about our Redeemer. Clap your hands, all you people. There are depths in God. One time I was visiting London and Pastor Lincoln told me this story and he said there is a prayer mountain in Wales where people go there to pray. He told me about this young lady that always prays. She's got a secular job. She's a messenger in the office. One day she was bringing something for the boss. Unawares, she had become transparent. So the boss saw a glass walking towards
her.
And she was unawares. The boss is an atheist. He collapsed and they called the ambulance. There are levels in God. 1999, I was preaching. I was preaching in
Nebbi.
I'm told that I turned into a flame. They could see my interpreter. Her name was Modesta. But they could see a flame talking. Not intercessors as Muslims. And they said after I became a flame, the fire made a circuit around the crusade. When the circuit was complete, the sticks of the cripples went up. In that crusade, I came back with over 20 crutches to Miracle
Center.
There are levels and realms in God that God is inviting you for. I hear the Lord say, come up here. Those who wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount upon wings as eagles. They shall run and not be faint. They shall walk and not be weary. I want you to make God your pursuit. Philippians 3 and verses 10. After Paul has seen it all, he says that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. and the fellowship of his suffering being made conformable to his death. When you set your eyes on seeing him, you will never cease to pray. Your prayer life will become stronger. I'll share one more and close. If you are going to pray strongly, you have to become aware of the rewards of prayer. Write this one down. Prayer is most rewarding. Prayer is most rewarding. Psalm 34 and verses 4 to 6. I sought the Lord and he answered me and he delivered me from all my fears. Those who look unto him are radiant and their faces shall never be ashamed. This poor man cried unto the Lord and the Lord heard him and saved him out of his trouble. Why do I pray? Because I know God is able to deliver me from all my fears. I'm here to declare tonight, I might be afraid tonight, but there is coming a day in my life when all my fears have been erased out of my life. God is able to obliterate them. What the energies of my prayer life are based on my conviction in the promises. He's able to deliver me from every fear of my life. If I can seek him, my face will become radiant. If I can seek him, I will not be ashamed in my generation. It doesn't matter where I am today. Those who are ahead of me, I'm going to find them. And it's possible that I'm going to overtake them. I will not be ashamed. Raise your right hand and say, I will not be ashamed. Come on louder, I will not be ashamed. Shout louder, say, I will not be ashamed. When you are convinced that is able to make your face radiant, that becomes a strong motivation, because it rewards those who seek him diligently. David said, he saved me from my troubles. I declare that in the next 11 months, there is no trouble that is going to be in your life. God has said in this service that is doing a new thing. You are going to be invaded by the new. The heavenly new is going to take over. A divine coup is in the offing. The new things of God are taking over your marriage. I challenge you to pray. I challenge you to call on him. You don't have to be an expert. If you can talk, you can pray. The difference is you talk to him and he's going to reward your moments of prayer. Psalm 65 and verses 2. Oh, you who hears prayer, to you all flesh shall come. The Father is a hearer of prayer. I want you to listen to me, my sister.
I'm declaring to you as a big brother, your prayers are going to be heard. Your prayers are going to be
harder.
I don't know when you are going to pray, but he's going to hear your prayers. Isaiah 45 and verses number 19, I did not speak in secret in a land of darkness. I did not say to the offspring of Jacob, seek me in vain. I, the Lord, speak the truth. I declare what is right. You can never seek him in vain. Your 10 minutes are going to be rewarded. Your 20 minutes are going to be rewarded. Your 30 minutes are going to be rewarded. It doesn't matter how long it has taken. The breaker is about to manifest in
your life.
Is about to divinely orchestrate a breakthrough. Tell two people your breakthrough is on the way. Your breakthrough is on the way. He's about to orchestrate a divine breakthrough. Your prayer times are going to be rewarded. Somebody shout hallelujah. I said, somebody shout hallelujah. I was preaching in
Birmingham
about 17 years ago, and they sent me a message that the government of Uganda is after us. We were on the front page of the New Vision. The case was a NEMA case. I knew we were finished. And so I sent a message back home. I said, cancel out every program. We are going to pray every evening. That year we prayed for 1 year. That year we fasted for 1 year. As I'm talking to you, we have a NEMA certificate. We have a permanent building. Everything that looked impossible, in heaven there's a God who answers prayer. Your prayers will be rewarded. You can never pray in vain. Somebody here, you are about to give birth to Samuel. Because Samuel means, I asked him from the Lord. You are going to have a Samuel in your family. You are going to have a Samuel in your finances. You are going to have a Samuel in your ministry. Jeremiah 33 and verse 3. He says, call upon me and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things that thou do not know. I'm about to find what I don't know. All I need to do is to keep on praying. I'm about to see what I don't know. All I need to keep on doing is to keep on praying. I'm about to stand where I don't know. All I need to keep on doing is to keep on praying. I'm about to touch what I don't know. All I need to keep on doing is to keep on praying. Call upon me and I will answer you, and I will show you great and mighty things that thou knowest. Let me give you 1 minute. Raise your hands to heaven and pray in tongues. Pray at the top of your voice. An unctional prayer is coming to us.
an unction of prayer is coming to us. Fresh fire on our altars. We are sharpening one another. We are encouraging one another. Pray loud enough for your neighbor. Pray loud enough for your neighbor. In the realm of the spirit, you can never survive alone. You need other people praying in the realm of the spirit so that you may keep on praying. Pray loud enough that you may stir up one another. Let prayer arise. Let personal prayer arise. Let individual prayer arise. They are going to pray for the next 10 years. They are going to pray for the next 20 years. They are going to pray for the next 30 years. Lord, I pray every altar that was quenched, let the fires be rekindled. 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 They will be consistent. Even if it's 20 minutes, even if it's 30 minutes, even if it's 1 hour, even if it's 5 minutes, they will be consistent. Let prayer arise. Let prayer arise. I feel it. I feel it. A mighty fire is coming over you. It's coming into your bosom. It's coming into your spirit. You will rise up. You will run and not be weary. 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 I command you to soar. Climb up on eagle's wings. Beginning tonight, I command you to soar. Climb up on eagle's wings. Climb up into greater heights. Ascend where you have never been before. Ascend in your prayer life. I release an ascension. I release a soaring. May your prayers begin to soar. In the name of Jesus. Raise your hands, everybody. Lord, I take my stand on this platform under the unction of dedicated authority. I'm legitimately here. I have a place in this house. The angel of this house has given me permission. I come against every destruction, every disturbance in the area of your prayer. I rebuke every inconvenience, even if it's poverty, even if it's lack, whatever robs you of your prayer time. I rebuke disorder in your family. I rebuke disorder in your marriage. I command the storm to cease. Every chronic illness that has been in your family, robbing you of your time of prayer, I break its power. I break its power. Anything that deters you from being that praying woman, from being that praying man, any moral weakness, I render it powerless. In the name of Jesus. Raise your hands. Any discomforting living. Any inconvenience because of your poor circumstances, I command that to change. I command your warfare to change. That you live in a good house. That you live in a cleaner house. That you live in a house where nobody is complaining that you are praying. In the mighty name of Jesus, I secure your accommodation. I command you to move into a spacious place. Raise your hands. Whatever was destructive, whatever was a deterrent, whatever was a roadblock, for them not to pray, I break it asunder. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I declare the wings are unclipped. The wings are unclipped. Now they are going to fly. Now they are going to fly. They are going to soar on eagle's wing. I want to give you half a minute. Clap your hands to Jesus. And receive it, receive it. Receive it, receive it. Receive it, receive it.